Good afternoon, Dr. Vikram.
Good afternoon.
Dr. Vikram, many people these days are suffering with diabetes, even in young age, they are suffering. So, how basically they suffer? Cause?
This disease actually has spread in epidemic proportions nowadays. Most of the, especially urban population, is suffering. And if you look at the data of incidence, from last 40 years, it has increased tremendously.
Okay.
Because that means the lifestyle has a great impact on this disease. So diabetes is called lifestyle disease.
Okay.
And lifestyle.
That's our, a lifestyle.
Yeah, about from last 30-40 years, our lifestyles have changed remarkably. Mm-hmm. Mobile phones have come, the computers have come, and people are sitting for long hours in their office. And the food habits have changed. Mm-hmm. The television has come, people they keep sitting in front of TV for long hours and eating and dining out and sitting in front of TV and just working at the workplace also they are eating fast food and just working for long hours. So the sedentary lifestyle is there. So this is one of the major reasons, sedentary lifestyle.
Okay.
The insulin is not able to cope up with the supply of glucose we are getting. We eat too much of this processed food, and that processed food is rich in calories, in glucose. And that glucose overload, the insulin, there is a small machine fitted by God in our body, fitted by God in our body, that is called pancreas.
Okay.
The role of pancreas is to keep control of the sugar levels.
Yeah.
So if you keep on putting in sugar levels and that machine gets failed, so that insulin is not able to control the sugar. So what is the solution? So many people
ask, that's the main question, how one can control.
So there are minor changes. First of all, I told you that you should early morning you should go for a walk.
Okay.
Walking is the best exercise. If you cannot go for jogging, if you cannot go for sports activity, at least walk.
Okay.
This is at least you can do. If you cannot go for swimming, if you are swimming, if you are doing sports activity, that is best.
Okay.
Cycling is best. But if you cannot do all these things, at least go for walking. You cannot sit for long hours. Even during the office hours, you can get off your computer seat and just have a stroll around at least office campus 2-3 times a day. Just take some small breaks. And meals also, you should not take heavy meals.
Okay.
Small meals with the salads and fruits,
which
easy
to digest
and rich in vitamins and nutrients. So it is very important.
Okay.
Stress and anxiety has very big role in causing diabetes. Because of fast lifestyle, the stress has become too much. People are earning money and spending money.
Okay.
And in that process, they are just scared of the future, fear of future. Of career, of exams, in students, of relationships, and so many fears nowadays. So this is also one of the leading cause of fluctuation in the sugar levels.
Okay.
So keep your mind cool, keep yourself relaxed, don't worry about the future. These are the basic things. And if the sugar has grasped you, if you have become diabetic, then what to do?
The solution is also required.
There are certain herbs which you can add to your diet, along with your online ongoing prescription medical prescriptions.
Okay.
You can add like fenugreek. Fenugreek seeds you can soak in some water and you can consume in the morning. Fenugreek is very good. This cinnamon is very good.
Okay.
Ginger is very good. Turmeric is wonderful. Turmeric, you can just take one spoon morning, evening, and you will see the difference in your sugar levels. And this tulsi is very good.
Very common also.
Yeah, very common thing.
Yeah.
Amla is wonderful. Just take one amla powder and this turmeric powder. That is called classical Nisha Amla Ki Yog. So that combination is wonderful. Amla and turmeric.
I think Indians are blessed because so many of the herbs you told, they are easily available.
The jamun, there is a fruit called jamun. The Java apple is called in English.
Very tasty. So very
tasty,
beautiful.
But the seeds of that fruit,
okay,
they are very useful. Even okay, the mango, the seed of mango,
okay,
if you dry it and make a powder, uh-huh, that is also very useful in diabetes.
That's great.
So the bark of mango tree is very useful.
Uh-huh.
Neem leaves are very wonderful. Neem is just the common neem, yeah, tree. You can take the leaves or even the bark.
Okay.
Very good. Kadi patta is a small plant.
Kadi leaves. Okay.
That is also very good. And so many herbs.
Uh-huh.
Bale is, there is a tree called Eagle Marmillose.
Yeah.
Bale tree, very
bale
common
tree, yeah,
in India. So the leaves of that tree.
That's
it. Sadabahar is a small Vinca rosea, very small plant.
Yeah,
beautiful plant.
Having purple and white
flowers. Yeah. So that leaves of that Sadabahar is very, uh-huh, good. And
really
there
great.
Is a Madhu Rakshak, Madhu Mehantak,
uh-huh,
powder.
Okay.
I have made a combination of all these to keep the sugar level in control.
Okay, these
so all these herbs we have put together, make Madhu Mehantak Churna.
Oh, okay, yeah, it's readily available.
Karela is a wonderful, Karela is bitter melon.
Uh-huh.
Bitter melon juice is very good. Shilajit also very good to prevent the complications of diabetes.
Okay.
So these are so many things. Ashwagandha is very good.
So Dr. Vikram, there are so many herbs available for diabetic,
yeah,
people and patients.
Yeah. So these should be used like this. There is a diabetes care package I have.
Okay.
Mixed all these,
okay,
supplements together to make fenugreek, this bitter melon and, uh-huh, Madhu Mehantak Churna.
So my basic question was, you told all about the herbs,
yeah,
but people exactly they don't know the proportion, in which proportion they should use.
Yeah.
It's good if you have something ready to use.
Yeah, something ready to use, a combo,
yeah,
package,
yeah,
combined.
In a proportionate manner. Yeah.
And they can be used along with the ongoing medicines.
Okay.
And you can just monitor your sugar levels,
uh-huh,
and they will slowly start coming down. They won't immediately come down.
Okay.
It will take 15 days, 10 days,
uh-huh,
and 1 month also. And slowly, once the sugar level is controlled, then slowly you can get rid of the modern drugs.
Okay. Dr. Vikram, my question is, there are many chronic patients of diabetes,
yeah,
as diabetes leads to renal failure and heart problems.
Yes, yes.
So if they are having renal failure or something heart problems, they,
yeah,
can also use this along with,
yeah,
their ongoing treatment?
They can also use this for keeping the sugar levels in control.
Okay,
so
they can add this
any
up.
Any patient who is suffering from any other problem,
uh-huh,
can use this, these herbs.
And one more question, Dr. Vikram. These herbs, they need to be used lifelong, or this can basically treat permanently?
I cannot say that it can cure your disease forever.
Okay.
But if you use these herbs for a few months, for 6 months or 1 year,
mm-hmm,
then you will see the drastic control of your sugar level.
Okay.
So even then, the levels will not fluctuate.
Okay. So control is also better.
Control is better. And moreover, there are no side effects using,
okay,
these herbs.
And Dr. Vikram, as this diabetes is called a silent killer,
yeah,
so if someone use herbs, is it still a silent killer or one can prevent?
Yeah, if the sugar level is in control, then there is no diabetes.
Okay.
So that is normal living.
Okay.
So that is not a silent killer. If you check your levels and if, mm-hmm, you are having no fluctuations in your levels, and if you are not having any elevation of sugar levels, then it is normal.
Okay, that's great. Thank you very much, Dr. Vikram. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.